It's a 3,000-kilometre drive from Darwin to Adelaide in Australia, but there's not a whiff of exhaust fumes. Or petrol, as these cars don't need to stop to refuel. They may look a bit flimsy and somewhat out of place in the rough Australian outback, but these vehicles can travel at up to 90 kilometres an hour, and they're all powered by the sun.
It's been going great so far, but we haven't made a lot of gains yet so far, and Aachen is still right behind us, so tensions are rising.
More than 40 racing teams from 24 countries left Darwin on Sunday. They're competing in the World Solar Challenge, which began 32 years ago.
We do have full trust that we'll be able to defend our title this year. The testing's been going really well in the Netherlands and in Australia.
But today's solar panels are half the size of those used in 1987 and deliver far superior results. The emphasis is on weight and durability as the cars almost silently glide through the Australian desert. They travel as far as they can until 5 in the afternoon. Then they make camp wherever they happen to be. It's a competitive race, but there's also a strong message about the future of motor transport.
The winds of change are gathering around global warming. This event is as relevant today, if not more relevant, than it was when we first ran in 1987.
It'll take the best part of a week to complete the 3,000-kilometre journey down the middle of Australia. And progress obviously depends on the amount of sunlight available. But in the wilds of the Australian outback, that's the very least of their concerns. Gavin Blackburn, TRT World.